Sessions. I am your host, Shannon Altner, May edition. We're popping it off right now. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for coming out. I don't know what the hell you're doing at home on a beautiful Friday evening, but I'm not complaining as long as you're tuned into us. We're on Channel 57 on Comcast, as well as 881 in HD, so I'm looking real fresh over there. Head over. As well as you can go to denveropenmedia.org, click on our live stream link, Channel 57, and you'll see us in HD there. So we've got a fantastic show for you all. It is jam-packed. We are overachievers tonight, but we're going to get it done for sure. So we have a Kickstarter going on, first off. So if you haven't heard about it, shame on you. That means you're not friends with us on social media. So head over to Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, get to Denver Open Media, Open Media Foundation, and become friends with us. Please, we'll let you know about all the wonderful things happening here in our community. But first off, we have a Kickstarter. So the Kickstarter is all about our new radio station launching next month. Let's give it up for that. It is going to be a crazy adventure for us. Thank you. 104.7 on the dial, but we need your help to make it possible. So we have a $25,000 goal on Kickstarter, and we are so close. We have 4 hours, and we're at a little over $19,000, as you can see. So in those 4 hours, we need $5,000, a little bit more than $5,000 to come in, and I totally feel it's possible. Don't you feel it's possible? It's so possible right now. It's at our fingertips. We're adventurers. All right, but we need your help to do it. I can't do it myself, right? So please, please, please head over to Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, denveropenmedia.org. There'll be a teal dropdown that'll take you right there to the Kickstarter page. Also, just go to Kickstarter, type in Denver Open Media, and it'll bring you right to the page. But what makes this radio station special is it's all local Denver content. So it's going to be a similar setup as our TV station, and it's really just going to be open to the community to give us content, and we're going to play it. So it's so exciting. So if you're a podcaster, you're a musician, you're a spoken word artist, you're a comedian, you've got content for us, we want it. We want to play it on the radio. We want to get your voice out there. And that's no exception for tonight. So tonight we're actually running a promotion. If you're at home and you're like, what? I'm a comedian. What? I'm a spoken word artist. What? I'm a musician. I'm going to stop that right now. But yes, if you're feeling that right now, I want you to come down here. We only have about like an hour left. We're taking submissions. So we'll take your content, we'll put it into our server, and then you'll actually get a basic membership to Denver Open Media. So we're giving 104.7 basic memberships away. So what that includes is that you'll be able to ingest content onto our TV and radio stations for an entire year. You'll also get a 30 to 50% discount on classes, and you'll get to come in and use our editing bays. So it's a great deal, and you get to put your content on the radio. So again, 104.7 of those we're giving away, and tonight is the night. So come on by. What we have going on for you this evening, even if you just want to come out and hang out with us, you're more than welcome to. Please, please, please. So we are in the Santa Fe District celebrating First Friday just like everyone else out here, 700 Calamath. And we have Crazy Mountain Brewing sponsoring us, Illegal Pete's, Sexy Pizza, Westward. We've got a whole bunch of treats upstairs waiting for you to enjoy, as well as a free show with all these fantastic people in front of me right now. Yes, thank you. So open music session. And what a show we have this evening. So as I said, it is jam-packed with goodness. We have comedian Rachel Weeks, who will be gracing our stage. Let's give it up for Rachel. And we have not one, but two musical guests, both bringing some hip-hop. So I'm ready to get down. I hope y'all brought your dancing shoes, ready to jive a little bit, because this is what I'm going to be doing all night. But Curto will be starting us off, and then Cubala will be finishing up. And Cubala was actually here for So Far Sounds, gracing the Denver Open Media stage a couple months ago. And some of us here at Denver Open Media were like, we got to get her out for open music sessions. And tonight is the night. So please, please, please stay tuned. So yeah, if you kind of popped over to Channel 57 or 881, and you're like, oh, that girl's kind of cute. Oh, that place looks fun. What's going on? So we're Denver Open Media. We are your public access station. Hi, how are you? You want to make contact? We're here for you. So if you're interested in being part of the media conversation, you've got something to say, you want a TV show, you want a radio show, we can help provide you with the tools and training for you to do that. So for our classes, we have field production classes, studio production classes, as well as editing classes. And we also give you the tools, the equipment for you to go out in the field, shoot whatever you want, shoot in our studio, do a live show. We're here for you. We are your creative resource. So if you are interested in that, please come down and visit us. We do tours every first and third Wednesday of the month. And then we also have fantastic events like this, like our first Friday open music sessions. So please, please, please come join us. And if you're in the house tonight, but you're not a member with us, we got a deal for you. We got a raffle going on. Can I get some oohs and ahs? Ooh, yeah, they like it. Oh, I got the ah too. Yeah, some follow-up. All right, so we do a raffle every first Friday. So if you're here in Studio A, you're up near the bar as well, please write down your information, throw it into the lucky glass jar of lucky luck. And we'll be pulling out a name at the end of the show this evening. I will be pulling the name. So put your good juju out there. You'll be receiving a free basic membership, so what I discussed before, as well as a free class. So we got a lot going on tonight. Let's give it up for that. Yes. And enough about me. Enough of the talking head, right? Let's get this show on the road. Hey, yo. Kelsey, you got my girl? Come on up here. Let's welcome Kelsey, our AmeriCorps VISTA, to the stage. She's going to do our community spotlight. And who do you have for us tonight, Kelsey?
We have the Denver Food Rescue here tonight. Okay. Can I get some noise?
Get some love. All right, I'm going to head off the stage and let you do your thing, okay?
Awesome. All right, so before I invite Amy from Denver Food Rescue up here, I just want to give you a little snippet about what the Nonprofit Spotlight is about. So every month we like to highlight the good work being done in our communities because these people, these organizations deserve a shout out. They deserve some love. So if you know a deserving nonprofit or individual, send them our way because we'd love to talk to them. We'd love to interview them. We'd love to spotlight them. Without further ado, let's give it up for Amy from Denver Food Rescue. How's it going tonight?
Good. Thanks for having me.
Good. Thank you so much for being here. I'm just really, really short.
I wore big heels, and I'm tall. I'm
I should take a note. Awesome. So, so tell us about what is Denver Food Rescue.
Yeah, so we are a nonprofit, obviously, working in Denver that has a mission to increase health equity in low-income neighborhoods by utilizing produce that would otherwise be thrown away from grocery stores and farmers markets. And we take it directly, and this is perfectly edible, beautiful produce. I'm sure you've heard the statistic that about 30 to 50%, we don't really know exactly, of our food farm to table in the United States and in the UK is thrown away. So we're also throwing away water and oil and all these things, right? And there's people, like 1 in 6 Coloradoans that are hungry, 1 in 5 youth that are food insecure. So we utilize this produce that is perfectly good to eat and take it directly to food desert neighborhoods. And we do this model because when DFR was figuring out what we were doing, we mapped where food deserts were, and this is communities that are at least a mile away from a full-service grocery store, and then they're often surrounded by fast food and convenience stores as well, which don't have very good nutritious food. And we found that these food deserts don't actually have traditional food banks located in them, so we thought, well, why don't we take the food directly to them? So we partner directly with community organizations that already have established trust in the community, and our programs are resident-led as well. So we have volunteers that 70% of the time use bikes and bike trailers to take the food, and we're talking like sometimes up to 1,000 pounds a week. But we do have shifts every day, but this is happening every day in America where we're throwing away just hundreds and hundreds of thousands of pounds of food. And so our volunteers take it, they just drop it off, and then the residents there of the community that we're working in set it up, and community members can access it for no cost, market style, and then take it home within the same hours as that food was like bound to be sent to the landfill. Instead, it's going to someone's table. So that's what we're about.
That is fantastic. Not only innovative, but sustainable and creative and really like helps build those quads when you're biking with 1,000 pounds.
It's great exercise.
Awesome. So where can people go to find out more?
Yeah, well, definitely Facebook and Twitter, right? And our website. You can. There's so many different ways to help out if you're interested. Obviously, volunteers. You don't have to use a bike if you don't want to. We can supply a bike, or you can use your own. Volunteers use their cars as well. But we also have obviously different support that you can give us, and we have a bike ride in August in Cherry Creek State Park. If you want to do a really casual, easy 15 or 30 mile ride, dress as your favorite fruit or vegetable, which is pretty fun. This is good. Yeah, that got cool last year. This is going to be our second annual, and this is what we do instead of having a gala or a dinner. So, you know, we want to be outside. We want to be riding our bikes. So if you want to get your friends together and do that ride, it's the second Saturday in August. If you want to volunteer, maybe you run a grocery store and you want to find out how you can get some of this produce directly to people that want it and need it. So, yeah.
That's amazing. Thank you so much for the work you guys are doing. Yeah.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, and I know that we have a video to play, right? Could you give us a little intro to that?
Sure. So we use this as a way to try to get volunteers. It kind of just is a look into what it's like to do a shift for DFR. So, yeah.
Here awesome. It is. Let's roll it.
Right now, in Denver, Colorado, your zip code impacts what you eat. The city's lowest income neighborhoods lack full service grocery stores. This means families in these areas have less access to healthy, fresh foods and higher rates of diet-related illness.
What it's given us is an outlet for food that would usually end up in a dumpster, a trash can, of no need, of no value. It's put it in the hands of people that could welcome it, enjoy it, and have a healthy choice.
Meanwhile, almost 40% of food produced for humans is wasted. Residents of these neighborhoods are getting organized, demanding better access to fresh produce and healthier lives. Denver Food Rescue is here to support these neighborhoods in their efforts. Every day, we pick up fresh produce that would otherwise be thrown away from grocers, wholesalers, and farmers markets all over the city and deliver it immediately, directly to community-based organizations working to make their neighborhoods healthier. To go where others cannot, to keep our footprint small, and to have the most fun, we do this on our bikes.
If I could say anything to the volunteers at Denver Food Rescue, I would say thank you so much. You have no idea what an impact you're making on the families in Denver.
We need you to join us. And in less than 45 minutes, you can deliver beautiful food destined to be thrown out directly to a family with barriers to fresh produce.
The most meaningful part of volunteering with Denver Food Rescue for me is feeling like part of the solution to some problems that need solving.
This is the cyclist way to make Denver a healthier and more equitable city. And this is the cyclist way to volunteer.
Let's give it up for our community spotlight, Denver Food Rescue. Yes, so if you are interested in getting involved, head to denverfoodrescue.org. If you're a cyclist, you want to work out those legs a little bit while doing some good for the community. And we love showing off nonprofits here at the Open Media Foundation. That's what we do. We work with nonprofits in the area, and it's fantastic to just have this time of the show to show the good coming through the Denver area. It's such a strong community. I'm so pleased. I just moved here a couple years ago, and it is just fantastic compared to other cities. So much love to Denver Food Rescue and to everyone that's helping them get their mission accomplished. So let's move to some comedy. I'm ready for some jokes. I've had some wine. I don't know about y'all. Can you tell by my teeth? Because Anthony Pritchard told me that I don't have wine teeth. But if anything, I'm going to attack him after the show if I do. Okay, so let's welcome Rachel Weeks to the stage. Let's give it up.
Well, hello, everybody. Hello, hello, hello. My name is Rachel Weeks. I'm excited to be here. I decided if I ever ran for public office, my slogan would be, "That'll take weeks." You know, I just want to be real clear with my work ethic, you know, with my constituents. I just want that to be clear. Just get that out there. I'm also relatively new to Denver. I moved here about 6 months ago. I think it's weird that I moved to Colorado specifically because I used to be so scared of drugs. Like, so scared. Like, did the DARE program just really work on anybody else? Yeah. For sure. I was so scared, and I didn't know anything about them. You know, like, I thought there was, like, four kinds of drugs, like arm drugs, nose drugs, lung drugs, and one of them had a spoon, and they were all bad, you know? All of them were so bad. Of course, the worst was marijuana, of course. That's the worst one. It's a gateway drug, right? You know, one blunt was the key to a prison yard of ne'er-do-wells, just huffing bowls and snorting needles. I didn't know what was going on. You know, it's confusing. I think it was just because the PSAs back then were so weird. Like, I mostly didn't do drugs because I didn't want to disappoint my dog. Do you guys remember that commercial? Right? Where there's like a cartoon boy smoking a cartoon blunt and there's a cartoon dog who says, "You disappoint me." Like, what? Dog who sleeps all day and eats whatever he wants? Dog? I have to go to high school and square dance with a limp-handed pervert today. Give me this, dog! Dog. Anyway, Denver rules. I'm glad to be here. I've had a really great time since I moved to the city. I moved here from Iowa. Which I love. Yeah, I love Iowa dearly. I think it's funny when I tell people that I moved here from Iowa, when I tell people that live in Colorado, they're like, "Oh my God, wow, wow, just congratulations, you know, you did it. You made it out of there, you know? You got in your car and you drove on that very well paid for highway and just got right out of there. Wow, it's good for you." It's the kidnapper state or something. It's not. They're great there. They always have questions. They're like, "Oh wow, Iowa. So is your whole system of government pulled pork sandwiches?" You're like, "No, actually, it's passive aggressive smiles." It's great. Thank you guys for coming and hanging out. Thank you guys for watching. Yeah, none of you like left your homes today and was like, "You know, today I want to see a dumpy Charlize Theron tell jokes." And here I am, you know, and here you are. So things, yeah, are going well for me. I like it. I'm glad. Some of you are like Charlize Theron. Oh, honey. Oh, dear. No. You look like Rizzo from Grease. You know. Yeah. She's the coolest 40-year-old high schooler I know, though. So she's rad. I'll take that. This haircut is new for me. This is a new thing that I'm working with. I like it a whole lot, but I've had to make some changes since I cut all my hair off. I started wearing more makeup and more dresses and stuff. You know, I just feel like I have to convince people that I'm an adult human woman who likes adult human penises, you know? People have questions all the time, so much. You know, I just don't want people to think that my main hobby is like jumping out of bushes and screaming, "The patriarchy!" You know? Like, I just want to be so fun. I just want to have a fun face. And instead, I just got this haircut. That's like a lecture waiting to happen, right? I come around corners. I'm like, have you checked your privilege? You know, like, I'm just, what are you doing? I like it a lot, though. I don't know how to put makeup on. I realized recently I have no idea how to do it. You know, I didn't have like a cool older sister to teach me how it goes. I was supposed to be the cool older sister, right? But I wore light wash flare jeans with an embroidered Chinese dragon down the side. So, you know, my siblings were screwed as well. These days, I guess you could use Pinterest, you know, if you want to figure out how to put your face on. But it's mostly 13-year-olds cutting their own bangs. And I feel like the other half of Pinterest like could have come out of the lifestyle blog of an old bridge troll. Do you know what I mean? It's like, steal an old wagon wheel, paint it orange, cover it in glass. Now it's a table. You know? It's just a weird website. It's weird. It's like,
Save 212 toilet paper tubes. Fill it with ground beef and cheese. Serve it as appetizers. It's just weird. You know, I don't understand. I've been working on sort of a long-term project from Pinterest. Been saving all my toenails and keeping them in a mason jar. Light it from below. Watch the lights dance.
Bro.
Yeah. But it's beautiful. The textures are really profound. You know that's not real, right? What if that was real? I just had jars and jars of fingernails and toenails lit in my, come into my apartment. I'm a bridge troll, you know? Full disclosure, I did use Pinterest to find this haircut. So, I think it's weird to use pictures, though, to find your hair, right? You're looking at pictures and you're like, is that a good haircut or just like a hot person? I can't tell. You know, it's hard because you need to be thoughtful about these things. You're not going to go in for a trim and come out with like a neater face and a thigh gap, you know? Like I tried. I'd still like this. People are like, Rachel, you want a thigh gap that bad? Go for a jog. You can do it. You could. It's like, no, I won't. I won't do that. I refuse. Mostly because I'm worried I might start a fire. Do you understand the amount of friction, the amount of heat that is happening? Has so many good genes lost to these thighs. Smokey says, only you can prevent thigh fat fires. And I'm doing my part, you know. That's what I do. It's for all of you. I'm trying to date. Yeah, yep, no, it's the worst thing. Are you kidding? Dating is the hardest, terrible thing ever, right? And we just pretend like it's normal and fine. Like everyone growing up is just like, get out there, you know? Get out there and open your heart. You'll find your one person amongst billions. Like there's one for you, just get him. Just go find him, get him in a net or something. I don't know how it goes. It's like, it's so hard. It's like playing Where's Waldo if you don't know what Waldo looks like, right? Right? You don't even get a clue. they're like, well, he wears a red striped shirt. Like, I don't know that. I don't know if he likes photography or if he like walks with a cane for some reason. It's fine. It's hard. You can laugh at it. I'm laughing at it. A lot of you are like, dear God, she's trying to find Waldo. She thinks it's real. It's totally, totally trying to do that. I don't know. I just think dating is so hard. You know, like I had a friend come up to me. She was like, I'm dating this guy, but I don't know how well it's working out. You know, he's got all these rules for me. And I was like, oh, no, he doesn't. No, he doesn't have rules for you. You're an adult human woman who likes adult human penises. You can find and make your own rules, girl. Yeah. You know, like a friend, I don't know. And then she said, you're right. The other day, he told me I couldn't eat in his bathtub. Yeah. Yeah, so I had to take it right back, you know? Whoa, what? You eat in another person's bathtub? That's like his tub, that's his domain, you know? It's like his plumbing bill that he has to figure out later. Are you kidding? What do you eat, you know? She said the weirdest thing. She said, nachos mostly. Yeah, I don't understand. So many loose pieces. What? It's like a spare jalapeno floating by, like sour cream swirling down the drain. That's so gross. That's horrible. She goes, no, Rachel, do you think I'm an idiot? You put it in a styrofoam container, it floats. Whoa. Duh. Yeah. Evil, disgusting genius, my friends. She's incredible. She's the best. I love her dearly. I don't know. I used to date, you know those guys, You know, like douchebags, you know those? I dated those, for sure. You know, the kind of guys that were just like, hey, you know, hey, I scored with a chick last night. I scored. You're like, oh, sweetheart, gross. What? Was she goaltending? Yikes, you know, that's insane. First of all, if you ever find a woman who is actively defending her vagina against you, get out. Get out of there. No, you're not wanted. Go away. No, you don't want a keeper at the gates. No, you want like a Walmart greeter, you know? Find yourself a lady in a blue polo. She'll be so happy to see you. Come on in. Come on in, you know? How many stores have you visited previously? You know, that many. Okay, let's go ahead and get you a bag, mister. Okay. Don't want you leaving anything behind, right? Keep that to yourself. Are you finding everything okay? I'm here to help, you know. Sir, okay. Are you finding everything okay? Okay, all right, what you're looking for is an aisle G towards the front. Top shelf, that's where that is. I'm mostly here to teach, to educate. That's my job. That's my job here. I didn't believe in God for a long time. That wasn't something I believed in until Fabio got on a roller coaster and was hit in the face by a goose. In real life this happened. In real life, Fabio went to Busch Gardens and was hit in the face by waterfowl. That's incredible. It's the only miracle I need to prove the existence of a creator. but I believe in God now, but I don't believe in like the crown and the thorns and the blood God. Like, that's a bit much, you know. I believe in like a goofy, silly guy, you know, just like the God who created like platypuses and penises and farts, you know, just like a real creative 11-year-old boy of a God. That's what I'm into. Like if Sid from Toy Story, like if his father loved him, like that's the kind of God I'd worship. I mean, because what are we if not spider robots with baby heads just clacking through life? I realized that it got weird, and some of you weren't prepared for it. I thought maybe a Toy Story reference would save it. It did not. But that's the end of my time. So we're going to end on this weird note. And I hope you enjoy the rest of the show. Hail Sid. Thank you. I'm Rachel Weeks.
My smile hurts. Like, seriously, it does.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for being here with us tonight.
Yeah.
So how can we connect with you online?
Yeah, I'm on Twitter at Rachel G. Weeks. Rachel G. Weeks, days and months. And I post all of my dates and like the shows I get booked on rachelgweeks.tumblr.com.
Great. What do you have coming up this month?
Ooh.
Anything for us?
I run a show. Well, I'm just starting a show at Berkeley Untapped. It'll be the fourth Monday of the month. And that's going to be really fun. We've got a great lineup booked this month. So it'll be fourth Mondays of the month at Berkeley Untapped. Okay. And then we run a show that's first Fridays of every month at El Chorrito.
First Fridays. You can do both, right?
We can do both.
We can do both. I couldn't today, but hey.
And are you going to ingest content onto our radio station? Perhaps?
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right. Let's give it up for Rachel one more time, everyone. Thank you so much for being here with us.
And I'll take that. I'm going to double mic it, you know? Okay.
So once again, Kickstarter people. Yes, we are counting down the hours, and we've got about $5,000 to go. So we need your help to make our Denver Open Media radio station, KOMF
104.7 happen. So 4 hours, please, please, please hop on Kickstarter.com, type in Denver Open Media, get to denveropenmedia.org, click that beautiful teal link on the top, and donate what you can to us. Every dollar matters. Please, please, please. It really doesn't matter if you got 50 bucks, you got $1 in the bank. Please give it to us and share online as well. We really appreciate it. And again, this is an all local Denver radio station, so there's really nothing like it here in the Denver area. We're going to give access to all sorts of artists in Denver for them to get their content played on our station. So with that in mind, let's head over to our Kickstarter video. Amy Goodman's in it. Yeah, the Amy Goodman. Let's do it.
Well, it's Denver 104.7, baby. Denver Open Media.
Turn that beat up!
When the Open Media Foundation had a chance to launch a new FM radio station in Denver with our friends at DenHack, we wanted to do something different. Coming June 3rd, Denver's gonna have just that. Denver Open Media 104.7 FM is gonna be Denver's newest radio station dedicated entirely to Denver.
We've got such a robust, diverse, vibrant music scene right here in Denver, Colorado, and it's time to have a new platform.
Like Denver Open Media's revolutionary TV stations, the community is gonna run this station totally themselves. You're welcome to become a member, submit any content you want, learn to use the equipment in the studios, and make your own radio show.
104.7 is a great resource for any Denver person trying to get sound waves out there. There are no gatekeepers. Podcasts, radio theater, radio drama. You can make whatever you want and it will go on the radio.
And then through the new denveropenmedia.org website, listeners are gonna be able to hear all the music, all the shows, and vote on the ones they like. And those votes will determine who gets the most repeat airings and the best primetime slots.
Vote for me!
I can't wait to hear stuff that I never would have heard even from going out to venues.
Fans of the local arts and music community, like me here in Denver, know that Denver is ready for its own radio station.
As a stand-up, I'm always performing, contributing, trying to write new things, and I want more and more people to hear what I've got to say.
I wink across the bar, I get a medic sent over to me. It's a different kind. Look like I'm having tiny seizures.
Running an FM radio station can be a costly endeavor. With our friends at DenHack, we're coming up with the most innovative, lean, and automated model anyone could imagine for an FM radio station. So much of what this new station needs to succeed is already provided by the community members who are providing content, by our partners at DenHack, and by the Open Media Foundation. But there are still some hard costs we need to get this station off the ground. Our goal for this Kickstarter is $25,000, which will cover the equipment, setup, website, insurance, and other basic utilities needed to get the station off the ground. So the real reward for helping with this project is that this city is going to have what it deserves, a new station devoted entirely to the creative community here in Denver. But if you want some other rewards, we've got some great ones from our partners and friends, from Denver Open Media and the Open Media Foundation, local musicians. Please take a look.
I know you'll be tuned in, so here's your chance to put your money where your dial is and contribute to the Kickstarter, help it get off the ground.
Contributing to 104.7 is contributing to something that's very unique, groundbreaking.
So please support what these folks are doing, because if we don't champion ourselves, no one's going to do it for us.
104.7 is where it's at. Let's go, Denver. It's time to get up.
Donate to our Kickstarter campaign. It'll really help us get the ball rolling.
Contribute to the Kickstarter and get this radio station started for Denver.
Support this Kickstarter. Let's do it.
All right, so once again, please head over to Kickstarter.com and support Denver Open Media in getting 104.7 launched next month for the creative community here in Denver. I want to say again, we have a lot going on here this evening. If you have content, you're chilling at home, you're right down the street, whatever, come on down, get that content ingested for the launch of our radio station next month, and you'll receive a free basic membership. We also have a raffle, so if you're in-house, write your information down, throw it in our lucky hat bowl thing, and I'll draw a name at the end of the show this evening. But without further ado, I'm ready for some beats and some jams. I don't know about y'all, I'm ready to drop it down a little bit. So, Kurta, let's do this.
Does everybody support that Kickstarter? We're gonna have it up to 23,160 by the time we're done with the set. Right. Is it cool if I'm not in my rap zone and my words seem well spoken but not thrown? They say I should rap an epitaph for my tombstone. I guess knock twice if I don't answer, I'm not home. My life needs a shot of testosterone. Big cystic sit buried deep and near the bone. Cause there's a model for the way that a baby's grown. Every culture artifice of a dead clone. Sometimes I feel so whack. My cadence carries slack. But is it cool if I just dress average and don't check accessories as overhead baggage? Swing myself like sack of cabbage. We dress nice but play like bad kids. One way for Americans to live. One way for Americans to live. Spin your gold then hide it in the twigs. Use the knife then wipe it on your bib. Sometimes I feel so whack. Other times I feel so da 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 da. And is it cool if I do not press cassettes? Only consent to consensual sex. First obsessed to pregnancy test. Next emptiness, then death. They say man has reached apex when work's prerequisite for checks. He's too intelligent to text, plus he knows what's next. If you're still perplexed, I will provide context. Blindness to kick bliss in the shin. Put my emotional win on display again. You suffer all day for him. You suffer all day for him. We suffer all day for him. Rhyme something smart with the word sin. Sometimes I feel so whack. Other times I feel so da 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 da. So many cameras that I'm trying to find out the best one to look at, you know, but I also want to monitor myself. This is a pretty good angle, actually. Yeah, Denver Open Meet is awesome. We're super stoked to be here. I've watched a bunch of these such sessions. It's cool to be a part of one. You want to play the song about annihilating things? Yeah? Make some noise for the master over here. Everyone, as far as I can see, is dressed famously. I'm pretending to integrate the distance between them and me. But stuck in, I'm simmering in subliminal thought, wondering why everything I think can be shopped. Well, why not? We don't stop and blame ourselves for acting the same. It's a survival technique for avoiding the pain. Replicate, let the breeders carry faith in the briefcase. Mortgages, down payments, pots in outer space. Replicate where you've wrung this faith in a suitcase. Gaze unto thy other wall, thy duplicator mate. Have I said yet to die to test the word crew? And don't mind at all what the lot of you were up to when they're through. Human beings at attention in columns of two, fixated to the ground by liberal. will begin in the cold, dark refrigerator. Tweak the settings on the auto thermostat incubator. Don't get between what they are and what they do. Manipulated by thumbs to annihilate you. Goose-stepping drones out, kids watch GIFs on flip phones. Working long distance and murdering from home. There's phantom vibrations here. We have let the co-pilot steer. Replicate, let the breeders carry faith in a suitcase. Mortgages, down payments, plots in outer space. Replicate, we have brung this faith in a briefcase. Gaze unto thy other wall, thy duplicator mate. Replicate, capitulate, then mitigate. Defend straight, you could debate, but they'll relate. I love your fate. My people don't make things, my people don't fix things, my people don't like things, or love things, or hate things. God ask us why we're covered in dust. Is it the suitcase bombers or the last gold rush? God ask us why our dreams all combust. Is it the rocket pack pioneers or the space lust? Our mothers in glass bottles, we're not of the earth's crust. Who cuss us, face exodus? Sentience, autonomy, and laws you're made to trust. Even unplugged, they still will kill stuff. Our batteries are up and you cannot erase us. Even unplugged, we still will kill stuff. Exodus.
A snot bubble behind my face for like a week and a half.
Oh, that's the end of the song.
I had a huge rice bowl for lunch today with my friend, and then we ate a bunch of marshmallows. We're like both the same age. It wasn't like me watching a kid. And he was like, we just made Rice Krispies. And that's like the best thing that's happened that I've heard said in a long time. So if you want that content.
There's a well of sadness in me, but I'm pissing in it. Tell folks to hold while I fidget with fingers. Another minute shy as a kid, now I flip kids left. But the clock still asks what our context is. Sip with straw beneath bubbles and fizz. Cannot parse money from a way how to live. Smile long enough to calcify, looking glib. They claim nectar in the thoughts. Well, here's one I've been taught. You can only get so far as that moment you're blazing hot. And we are not all rock, we are not all pop. My friends will cackle into faces till the genre games stop. With plop, plop, plop. Categories all cadaverous, my well of sadness cavernous. Plus I can't find silly bliss inside of two whiskey fifths. Sing, I know what my purpose is. Like, I know what my purpose is. Lying to these kids. We are lying to these kids. Thank you.
Jared said I have a lot of words in my head like a novelist, but he meant it as a diss. Can't reminisce too much, must rap on top of this, must find my strength, metastasize metropolis like rap battles won with onomatopoetic hiss. These people really, really, really fear apocalypse. It's fairly obvious the way their teeth show through their lips, and I get pissed when my art friends say quit. We were snug for a minute like an internet click. Grab my jacket if you slip, use my microphone to rip. Hey, these headphones couldn't even fit, just make our hips twitch and trick. We'll brew some coffee so that then you can sip, and if your blood runs thin, my head will be thick. We could avoid that dictator shaking his bejeweled stick. Sing, I don't know what my purpose is. Like, I don't know what my purpose is. Lying to these kids. Kill the photogenic and practice your calisthenics. I made frenemies and even excluded by a newsfeed. You're still a real musician when your beat's made by weed. Or a scared little nubby one that smiles while they leave that dust. This horse, he wants to buck me. Why had I expected the weather outside to be lovely? Life is short and ugly like the bride of Chucky. I've got all this Harvard LSD. Why won't anyone touch me?
We're playing new material. Hey, how's that Kickstarter? What's that Kickstarter at? There should be a guy on the numbers that just yells the numbers out every couple minutes.
1 million.
1 million. Brent's estimate was 21,623. That's the only reason I know such a specific number is because it's an estimate. So we're going to play another new song, and then when you get out of here, Cubala's going to come up, do her thing. Make some noise for Cubala. She's the reason we're here. Yeah, I'm finding out, we're still figuring out which ones are cameras. This song's called Goldilocks. It's another happy one.
We could be so much more than dancing to a groove. Perform spin moves and pretend you're astute while standing fully nude. We were drunk on linoleum and kicking cat food. Made eye contact and then revealed to me a clue. But why would you say that? Don't you know that you can't take it back? No, you can't take it back. I said that you can't take it back. Plus, I should have stood up and just done more dishes, but moved in diagonal patterns then like a piece called the Bishop. Young Wolf Pup World had me by the scruff. Pretend to be real, boy. Pretend to act tough. Screaming in airships like death from above while thinking quietly, folks, interchangeable. How parts wear rubber gloves. What if I told you my trajectory's a near miss? Would you offer up condolences or feed my ego a kiss? Why I fake project a lonesome night to paint the brightest stars? Now sit and spend time wondering precisely how far this off-lost brightest beam shines through my pocket seams, and each binary pair could lean to what I want to be seen. It's a lot like that movie screen, except the color palette's dead, except it's all inside my head. Already wrote about the color red. Learn to dance to pounding fists. We are cantankerous. Learn to dance to pounding fists, cause we are cantankerous. Ulterior motives. Truth is, we vote for some tadpole who then controls the explosives. You can bum my secret language mask if feeling suicidal or beaten on and broken in by not receiving titles. It'll engorge cortex, help dodge a hex with quick steps. Surviving now like a water boy hidden inside the home team's sweats. We've got no one to complain to when our socks get wet. I know privilege is owning three pets and direct withdrawal rent checks. Sitting on a patio, your cup of lover's breast, the sun will gawk because you're perched upon a tinderbox nest. We're not the best, but we rock these beats a lot. We rock these beats a lot. Hey, Chris, don't call me Goldilocks. We're not the best, but we rock these beats a lot. We rock these beats a lot. Hey, Mom, you raised a Goldilocks. We're not the best, but we rock these beats a lot. We rock these beats a lot. Please don't call me Goldilocks.
Hardware over here. I'm impressed. Those beats were. Oh yeah, it's all for show. There's nothing. Don't worry about this. This is just like Wizard of Oz. Don't worry about that. That's nothing over there.
There's an iPod underneath all of it.
Yeah.
He just said that, and then I amplified it.
Technology these days.
You all laughed at me. Thank you.
More and more convenient. So where are you all playing next? Where can they connect with you?
We're playing Marquee Theater on Sunday, the 15th of May.
All
with
right.
Mac Lethal. He's a YouTube phenomenon. You guys should come check that show out. That'll be awesome. And then you can connect to us on the internet.
Where?
I've heard we're viral. I don't know what that means, but it sounds dangerous. So if you do connect to us online.
I think that's a good thing.
Oh.
I think.
Yeah, Curta Music, at Curta Music, pretty much anywhere on the internet.
All right, great. So Curta, check him out. Let's give him one more round of applause. And let's get Kubala up on this stage.
Yeah, thank you, Kubala.
Yes, thank you for coming out and showing your talents and participating in our show this evening. We really appreciate it. So let's give it up one more time. And Kubala, let's do this. Wait, hold on. We're not ready yet. You need a little bit more of this right here. I know, guys. So Kickstarter, yes, still. We're still talking about it because we still need about $5,000, right? Can we pull that up really fast? Are we at 21,613? I think that's what they estimated. Ow! Oh, okay, we just got a $100 donation. I like seeing that. but yes, we still need a little over $5,000. So please hop on social networking, hop on Kickstarter.com, as well as, wait, what? I have a whole bunch of people talking to me right now. I'm sorry, I can't even. So we're gonna take a break. We're gonna watch a video. We're gonna watch a Kickstarter video. That's what we're gonna do right now. Yeah, let's do it again, go.
Well, it's Denver, 104.7, baby. Denver Open Media.
Turn that beat up.
When the Open Media Foundation had a chance to launch a new FM radio station in Denver with our friends at Den Hack, we wanted to do something different. Coming June 3rd, Denver's going to have just that. Denver Open Media 104.7 FM is going to be Denver's newest radio station dedicated entirely to Denver.
We've got such a robust, diverse, vibrant music scene right here in Denver, Colorado, and it's time to have a new platform.
Like Denver Open Media's revolutionary TV stations, the community is going to run this station totally themselves. You're welcome to become a member, submit any content you want, learn to use the equipment in the studios, and make your own radio show.
104.7 is a great resource for any Denver person trying to get sound waves out there. There are no gatekeepers. Podcasts, radio theater, radio drama. You can make whatever you want, and it will go on the radio.
And then through the new DenverOpenMedia.org website, listeners are going to be able to hear all the music, all the shows, and vote on the ones they like. And those votes will determine who gets the most repeat airings and the best primetime slots.
Vote for me!
I can't wait to hear stuff that I never would have heard even from going out to venues.
Fans of the local arts and music community, like me here in Denver, know that Denver is ready for its own radio station.
Radio!
As a stand
stand-up, I'm always performing, contributing, trying to write new things, and I want more and more people to hear what I've got to say. I wink across the bar, get a medic sent over to me.
Running an FM radio station can be a costly endeavor. With our friends at DenHack, we're coming up with the most innovative, lean, and automated model anyone could imagine for an FM radio station. So much of what this new station needs to succeed is already provided by the community members who are providing content, by our partners at DenHack, and by the Open Media Foundation. But there are still some hard costs we need to get this station off the ground. Our goal for this Kickstarter is $25,000, which will cover the equipment, setup, website, insurance, and other basic utilities needed to get this station off the ground. So the real reward for helping with this project is that this city is going to have what it deserves, a new station devoted entirely to the creative community here in Denver. But if you want some other rewards, we've got some great ones from our partners and friends, from Denver Open Media and the Open Media Foundation, local musicians. Please take a look.
We know you'll be tuned in, so here's your chance to put your money where your dial is and contribute to the Kickstarter. Help it get off the ground.
Contributing to 104.7 is contributing to something that's very unique, groundbreaking.
So please support what these folks are doing, because if we don't champion ourselves, no one's going to do it for us.
104.7 is where it's at. Let's go, Denver. It's time to get up.
Donate to our Kickstarter campaign. It'll really help us get the ball rolling.
Support this Kickstarter. Let's do it.
Please support Denver Open Media's new low-power FM station. Thanks so much. I'll be
fading. All right, I told you Amy Goodman was there. I told you, and there she was. So go to Kickstarter.com. Please contribute to our radio station. We're trying to launch next month, 104.7, bringing all local Denver content. But in the meantime, I think we should enjoy some damn good music. What do y'all think, right? I know Kubala is ready to bring it. So let's welcome her to the stage. Kubala, do your thing.
Thank you for having me. I'm really excited to be here. How y'all doing tonight? Yeah, heck yeah. I had a great time the first time I was here for So Far. Now I'm back again. So I brought some extra pizzazz. Last time I didn't do some of this stuff, so this is the fun part of music is the creativity, so we just stay in that, right? Woo. You can cheer that.
Yeah.
Q-Q-Baller. How y'all doing? All right. My name is
Q-Q-Baller.
Not sure if you knew that.
Q-Q-Baller.
Get some shit like this.
Any idea who'd have it?
Me, Q-Baller on the streets. What the fuck just happened? Q-Baller on the beat. Goddamn, I don't know. She got mad with the flow. Out of control with the sick instrumental. Gonna get it when I come through the spitting. Q-Baller grip the microphone. I ain't kidding. I got what it takes to flex. No dex. Q-Baller coming through. Keep the rap game in check. Cause I'm Q-Baller. Q-Q-Baller. And I'm killing on these streets. And I'm killing on these beats. Cause I'm Q-Baller. Q-Q-Baller, and I'm just doing me and living that creativity. Q-Baller, Q-Q-Baller, and you better let them know who brought that extra flow, cause I'm Q-Baller, Q-Q-Baller, Q-Baller, Q-Q-Baller.
Q-Q-Q-Q-Q-Q-Q-Baller.
Come on, put your hands in the air. Jump, jump like you just don't care. Now we get on to the rapping. Here we go. Come on, get your hands in the air. Y'all ain't gotta stay on your butts there either. Come on, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh boy, got some hate to step to the mic and get X with a fader. I never claim to be, but apparently the player that everyone's trying to catch up to. So waiters, I'm on top, yo, I'm bottom. Never know until you try, so just keep talking. Just keep stalking, matter of fact. Find yourself on the outside of this black ass. Quick to toss the match, you watch the ass burn. I die half to this bullshit, they don't learn. Who wanna step to the plate to get the own turn? Which is kinda funny since it ain't never to my face learn. It's always to the vines, my Facebook line. Matter of fact, this shit's just fine. They don't really like me cause I got a better stack. Find yourself getting pricked by the needle in the sack. Right now. after each one of these songs, I'm supposed to let y'all know a little bit about these tracks. That track has actually never been recorded. This is the first time that that track has ever been recorded. Yeah, and I do some of that sometimes just because those are special moments that you get where you are the ones that actually show up to the show. So my internet fans that have never seen me play, they don't get that, you know. But now they're gonna get it, so they're getting a little lucky with that. But that track discusses a lot of stuff, and I've always wondered if anybody would ask me about a certain line in it, and I make a reference to Justin Bieber and young gentlemen actually kind of making awkward eyes at me from the stage or from the bottom, from down here in the crowd. And I never, this is the funniest thing, because when I get up here, I'm just letting loose. My fiance, she's amazing, bless her. She's letting me know, like, hey, did you... She people watch. We people watch. I don't know if you all people watch. I do it. People watch. But she's telling me, hey, you know, I was watching this guy watching you, and it was kind of creepy. I was like, what are you talking about? I was like, well, it was weird because his attitude was really like hard all night. Like it was like, you know, it was like he was faking. You know, it was faking that it wasn't someone that he really was. And then all of a sudden, like maybe through listening to some of these songs or some of my music, he kind of like opened up a little and was like, hey, I can be myself. I don't know. I think there's a lot of labels out there that we put ourselves inside of that were already set there and then we live in them. But I think if we break free of those labels, we can actually be the brilliant, radiant people energy that we have always been meant to be. And so when this song kind of challenges those things, and I have kind of like a boom bap slam style way of throwing stuff into songs. And so, I mean, part of the song could have been from 10 years ago. Part of the song could have been from the week that I wrote it. It's all very relative into my personal life. And it's always this reminder of, don't be afraid to live. Always live. Be you. If I die tonight going home, I better have left it on the stage, right? I better have been myself. I better have done those things because I deserve that. Y'all deserve that. And that's what those lyrics are kind of challenging. So that track is called Ooh Boy, recorded the first time here. So thank you guys for being a part of that. We're going to keep it going. I've never actually stopped and talked this much during tracks, but we're going to get live and just keep going. Is that all right with y'all? All right, because I like doing that. It's fun. Yeah, this track is called We Ride. It's off Dark Side of the Rain. We ride. Yeah. Yeah. We ride. Take control. Let your mind go overload. Come on, overload. Rewind. Take it slow. Gotta get right. Let's go. We mind. Blow that smoke. It don't mean we high. No. We ride. Work hard. All day, all night, lie. 1 month ago, yo, I quit my job and I don't quit-ish. Doctors telling me the truth, shoot. I think I need another hit, not to get high, just to get by. Poli looking at me funny while I drive by. It's just another day, another pill away. Got me feeling ill in a different way. I'm chucking in the trash. I've always been about the dash, but truth be told, I'm iron on that cash. My girl looking at me, my face, saying we'll be okay, like... Honestly, I'm questioning if I can even move a muscle today. Like, 9 to 5 got me feeling like a slave. Plus the sports, a man dingo playing for pay. But don't get it twisted, cause I'm still getting paid when I play. Puffing on a Larry J, like magical moments. Captured in a studio, I hope it makes you feel good. Like rolling with a girl with a big booty though. Mine's a cutie roll, she said she ain't like this part of the song. So I took hits from the bar, then I strategically placed these balls in order for her to sing along. Lie. Man, we come a long way when that frustration hits. Come on, yeah, I let my jam play. We ride, take control, let your mind go overload. Set overload, rewind, take it slow. Gotta get right, let's go. Let your mind go overload. Say it overload. Rewind. Take it slow. Gotta get right. Let's go. Oh, let's go. We might blow that smoke. It don't mean we high. No. for you guys. Crowd participation. That kind of energy gets us MCs up here going. Crowd participation, that's huge. If you can get people moving on that same vibration as you, like, whew, that's monumental. That track, all right, so Dark Side of the Rain, I released it as the first part of my next album that I released after that, Battle Cries. And the first line of that track, and I do this sometimes, like, I'll just go on these little spurts and only write, like, a verse, and then write, like, a little chorus after it and just kind of feel it out, and then don't do like a whole song like you normally, you gotta do 16s, and I'm just like, it's art, and I'm creating, and this is where my space is, so see ya. Just joking, I don't do that. You perceive my art how you like, and that's cool. That's what the beautiful thing about art. But no, the first part of this verse, I say that I quit my job, and now I'm back working, and I'm actually working more than I was working then. At that time, I was diagnosed with MS after a horrible car accident that a music partner and a friend of mine got in, and it was crazy. I played college basketball, so at that time, I was playing basketball, I was playing shows. I was a pit boss at a barbecue restaurant doing my thing, and the car accident happened. A few months later, diagnosed with MS and lost, like, insane amounts of energy and strength, and then I bounced out of Colorado, went on several tours by myself, went to Chicago, Minnesota, and Wisconsin, and was just like, I'm doing this. I'm tired of beating myself up every day, but I'm still realizing, like, oh wow, you're gonna have to beat yourself up a while if this is something that you're really gonna chase after, if you wanna play music for the rest of your life and be able to be in that healthy mental space. This is where I'm the healthiest, doing this. So these songs, I really dive into my personal life and the things that are going on. And as soon as I say it out here, I can hold myself accountable for it even more, because I kinda cheat by telling y'all what I'm thinking I need to be doing. And then I know that y'all know, so then I have to get my grind on, right? Because I got all y'all counting on me to do big things with my life, just as I count on y'all to do big things with your life. We all share this space, and there's enough space for us all to do beautiful things. That track is called We Ride, and yes, I don't know how many people smoke herb, but I've stood in Sarah Palin's office. I've been on, played basketball overseas, the NCAA championships. I smoke weed. I grow it, and I understand one thing. Let's get back to our green thumbs. Let's get back to our roots and actually understanding how to take care of ourselves on a healthier level. You know, vape, eat edibles. If you can't smoke, smoke can really hurt you. It's still a carcinogen that affects you. It's inflammatory. So, you know, it's like throwing gasoline on a fire. If you're already hurting, weed doesn't do the same thing as it used to when we were kids. Now we got to think about how we administer that stuff. You know, how do we get from here to here? This is how I do it with my music. A little bit of herb, a little bit of grind, a little bit of sweat, some tears. I cry a lot. But who doesn't, right? All right, this next track is called It Takes More. I'm just going to stop talking. Thank you, guys. Oh, wow. Denver Media, y'all are awesome. All Denver Media. Honestly, this last year has been insane, and I'm looking out in the crowd and seeing several people that I've interacted with over the last year. Thank you for continuing to invite me back. It means the world to me, and if I can open the doors for artists like Curta and other artists who are trying to do what they want to do, heck yeah, this is amazing. This is amazing to be a part of, so thank you all for being here, and thank you for inviting me. I'm honored to be here. Thank you. Thank you. I don't think I said thank you enough. I probably thank you for the rest of my life, because this is monumental and life-changing. Every moment that I get to make music and create music helps me grow and just makes me feel better about being a part of this big universe that we are a part of. So let's keep playing music.
Follow me now. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. I was the rook, she was the queen. I had to check the mate in between. The plan was to learn common patterns, anomalies, luring me to different scenes. I could see 64 squares smoked by a fucking palm fiend. This is the life on an 8x8 grid. Get you caught up, angry bishop, cut you off the angry kid. A 2 to 3 a bit, living hope without. Only should have lasted 60 minutes, abstract, no doubt. Strategy got you locked in stalemate. You got to get your shit right. Well, Dustin, you'll be left on your own quest. Trust nothing but a pawn left, feel me? Little girl, it'll be alright. Take my hand, I'll guide you through the waking hours of the night. It takes more than a man to kill my plans. I figured out how to put anything I want in my hands. It takes love. Oh, it's love. I gotta give it up to the ones who show me the way of the righteous ones. Now I gotta make a choice. Do I give it back to you? Only if you make some fucking noise. If there was a piece named death, it would all make sense. I cringe, refer them to them both in past tense. Finally, lyrics to the sequence. Pay the rent in my mind's eye. But ahead of the time went. Swept away like 16 pieces on a foiled servant trail. Fell victim to the game, losing teeth like chess pieces. Reaching for my bishop to pass forgiveness over sins. Whoever catch checkmate loses, yo, I win. Never have I ever. No, I can't play that game of life without my little cousin. Just ain't the fucking same. Another 2 years high, gotta blow my brains out. Higher than this fucking sky. Yo, I'm reaching for my guys like I got some place to be. I got to place these trees. Someone please get these mind-sucking people to safety. I'm about to pull the pin. Ah, hell, everyday life drops the beautiful petals of sins. Well, little girl, it'll be alright. Take my hand, I'll guide you through the waking hours of the night. It takes more than a man to kill my plans. I figured out how to put anything I want in my hands. It takes love. Oh, it's love. I gotta give it up to the ones who show me the way of the righteous ones. Now I gotta make a choice. Do I give it back to you? Only if you make some fucking noise. Little girl, it'll be alright. Take my hand, I'll guide you through the night. It takes more to kill my plans. Yeah, you gotta put it in your hands. Little girl, it'll be alright. Take my hand, I'll guide you through the waking hours of the night. It takes more. Oh, baby, it takes more. Thank you. That track is called It Takes More, and it is also off Dark Side of the Rain, and I had so much fun writing this track. I bought a dry erase board, and this is probably the smartest thing an MC could do, or anyone, actually. You should just be writing stuff down, follow yourself with notes everywhere you go. If you're like me, you're forgetful. But anyways, dry erase board in a studio, it's massive. It's like the size of one of these things, and you can just sit here and write lyrics and erase it if you don't like it, or keep it, take a picture of it and write them down later, whatever. You're not shredding through paper with a pen and a pad, and I like to write with a pen and a pad. But this song in particular, I had this story that just kept coming out every time I was freestyling to it, and the way that I attack songs is different each time. It's just really how the beat kind of, how the energy kind of flows between the beat and myself. And this song, I just kept hearing strategy and, you know, like, I gotta grow from something. And so I took the game of chess, and I don't play chess. I stayed away from it because I used to get my butt beat by my brother in every video game when I was a kid, and then he started playing chess, and I was like, nah, I'm good. I beat you at basketball one time. I'm good. Retired. So anyways, I took the game of chess. I took all of the pieces, all the characters, some of the strategy, put it all up on the board, and then I started plugging in just these little pieces into, like, in characters and just kind of writing this story. So I was the rook, she was the queen. I had to check the mate in between. The plan was to learn common patterns, anomalies. So in chess, you want to learn your opponent's common patterns. What stands out as an anomaly, you know, all this strategy. In that line in particular, I'm actually talking about my now fiance, and obviously I won that game of chess. So I was the rook, she was the queen. I had to check the mate in between. I kept kind of like trying to come back, and it's like, man, if you like it, you should have played it. You know that one song by Jurassic 5? I was checking. But no, there's, so in this song in particular, I don't just talk about her, I talk about
some other females in my life that were friends that had gone through struggles. I see myself as a kid going through these struggles, and little girl, it'll be all right. It will be all right. I can reach back to that old me. Anyone could reach back to that old you and pull you back here. You know, you gotta kind of keep that in a little bit of a Pandora's box and have respect to your past, but you can't dwell on it, you can't live in it. So that song in particular kind of is helping me grow through some of those childhood mess ups that I did, and then even into now of how to just be confident. That's a lot of my music. Be confident, be yourself. Do you. We're gonna keep going, all right? You all right with that? I'm just joking. I'm teasing you. All right. Get some water here. I'm thirsty. Word up to all you workers out there, working bees. We're all working out here in the streets. Do-do-do.